In this class, okay. We have just two goals. The two goals are, the first one is to have a fun. The second one is speaking English. Do you agree, guys?
To have fun,
Yeah.
you say to have fun? Did
Yeah, have a
you?
fun.
Yeah, have
Yes,
fun. Yeah.
I agree.
Me too.
Also happy to hear that you want share with me. Everybody's agree is to share to do these two things. Okay, I'm going to just speak maybe 2 minutes. Okay, the instruction in Spanish, and later no more Spanish. Or for you, do you feel comfortable just in English, or do you want me to speak just the instruction in Spanish?
For me, it's good in English.
For
Okay, please.
me, it's good in English.
Guys, if at least one person wants in Spanish, please let me know. Si algo, al menos una persona quiere que lo diga en español, por favor, díganmelo.
Yo, por favor, yo sí en español.
Ok, en esta clase solo vamos a contar, bueno, ya con 50 minutos. Tenemos dos objetivos, solo dos objetivos, pasárnosla lo mejor que podamos, eso depende de cada uno de nosotros. La otra es hablar en inglés. Todos los que estemos aquí nos vamos a hacer el propósito de que vamos a hablar en inglés, no importa lo que digamos, solo vamos a hablar en inglés. ¿Están de acuerdo?
It's
Yes.
okay.
¿Tienen alguna pregunta? Que quieran que responda en español, o otra cosa, cualquiera de, nos, de nosotros, cualquiera de los participantes, por favor, siéntase con toda la libertad de marcar si yo pronuncio mal, cualquiera que nos quieran hacer una corrección, es bienvenida, por favor, todos tenemos esa habilidad, todos sabemos, estamos en diferentes niveles de inglés, todos tenemos esa habilidad de poder corregir a alguien y sabemos que es para y mejorar nuestro inglés. ¿Tienen alguna otra duda, algo que quieran que lo hablemos en español?
No.
Ok, I'm going to speak in English and now it's just going to be in English. Ok, as I was saying, we have just two purposes. The first one, have a fun. Second one, just speak in English. And everybody, please, please help into this class. If everybody can listen, somebody's like saying little funny way and not in the proper way that we are speaking, please correct to us. Everybody will appreciate because we are for this purpose here, right? Just to improve speaking English and enjoy. Like no pressure, no feel like uncomfortable, like I don't know what to do. Like now, my hands are like wet. I'm sweating. I said no, I shouldn't do that, but my ego is betraying me. Okay.
Oye, and another thing, it's for free, so you don't have to be nervous because it's for free. Nobody is paying for this class, so nobody is going to sue you.
But you know what? That doesn't matter. My ego doesn't know about that. My ego is like, I don't care. It's what it is. It's not about money. It's about maybe I feel insecure. It's about that. Actually, my ego doesn't know about money. I don't know if somebody's like me. I don't know, guys. Okay. And the topic of this, I would like to know, Neto, how many attendees do we have? Divide the time. Because I would like, please, everybody speak in Spanish, in English.
Yes,
This.
we have now seven persons. I mean, not counting us, there are
Okay.
six persons. Not counting us, just six persons. So if you divide the class in six persons, it's going to be like 8 minutes each one, I think.
Oh, good. That means we are good. Okay, now is 8:11. 11 after 8, I think we can start. We are just 6 persons. Everybody can speak 8 minutes. It's good, right? Because we have the chance to, maybe everybody can speak, I don't know, 5-6 mm-hmm. minutes, and we have 2 minutes to correct or to continue with the topic that the attendee is sharing us. Okay. Okay. The topic of this class, because it's the very first class for me, I got the idea. Okay. The topic is tell me about your very first experience in, I don't know, anything you can tell me. Maybe your very first date, online date, or your very first day at work, or if somebody remember his first poem, love poem for a girl or for a guy, or if everybody remember his first kiss. Yeah. Okay. If, I don't know if somebody want to start, or do you want me to start my very first time?
Somebody's pointing you, Marta. So you start, Marta.
Okay, I'm going to start. Okay, guys, as I'm saying, I don't know why my ego is like betraying me, but I'm trying to put it away. Okay, as I said, I got the idea because this one is going to be my very first time guiding an English conversation class. So I don't know further, right? Because we are now in the class. But I can tell you guys about it, what happened to me previous to the class. Okay. Always for me, when I'm going to face a situation where I don't know, and it's going to be like my very first time, I got a horrible nightmare. I didn't expect this, but it happened to me yesterday night. I got a horrible, horrible nightmare. Always is exactly the same nightmare. It's like I am trying to go upstairs and I cannot, because the stair or the escalator doesn't have steps. It's like flat, and I'm trying to go up, but I cannot because there is not steps on the escalator. There is not, and I wanted to go, and I cannot go. This happened to me, and I was in France with my girlfriend. The last time that I was in France, it was in 2017, and I could speak French in a good way. I was able to speak with everybody, and it was okay for me. But I don't remember, if now you are asking me, I cannot speak in French right now, or I'll be like blah, blah, blah. And I can understand everything, but I won't be able to speak like with this fluency in Spanish or English. So in my nightmare, I was trying to go up because I was on the subway. Always is in the subway. No, sometimes it's in the subway, sometimes it's... In a house or any place, but there is escalator and I need to go up and I cannot. I was there in the subway. I was trying to go up to the subway, to the street, and I couldn't because the stair didn't have the steps. So my girlfriend was telling me, come. And I said, je ne sais pas. Dema. And I was like, and I couldn't. I was like sweating, crying, and I couldn't. And I wake up like, oh my God. And I said, it's because I'm going to have the English class. So guys, this is my experience. So far is just that one. And now I don't know if somebody wants to be the second person.
Okay, continue with the person who opened first the microphone is the next person who wants to okay. share the first experience.
Or somebody wants to, I don't know, who is going to be the second one, or if nobody wants to be the second one, yeah, somebody
Aurora,
can.
Aurora already opened the mic.
Thank you, Aurora.
I just want to say, I think this level is difficult. It's a little difficult for me. I understand more than I can speak. Then I understand you almost everything, but I think I could not speak so quickly as you did. It's difficult for me.
Oh, thank you. Do you thank you. I'm going to speak slowly. So sorry. I didn't know that I was speaking very fast, but now I think your English is, I could understand you everything. Please, can you tell us your very first experience now?
I understand you everything. Your speed is good for me. I understand you. The difficult for me is speak, okay? I need practice to conversation.
Okay, now you are in the right place. Speak, tell us about your first okay. experience. Everybody is like waiting for your first experience.
This is my first experience in online English class.
Great.
I think the last time I spoke in English, it was very years ago. It's difficult for me to talk. Okay?
I don't think so, because you are speaking, now you are speaking, I don't know, where are you waiting for? Just tell us your first experience. And I'm going to try to, as I said, if I notice something, I'm going to let you know. And please, if everybody knows something for me or for everybody, please tell us, guys.
Okay, I prefer somebody goes now, and I'm going to see what happened with me in a few minutes more, okay?
Oh, you won't tell us your very first experience?
But in what?
As I said, if you see, it says, I don't know, your very first experience as I write in a poem, or having your very first boyfriend, when you got married, because, or maybe you got married twice, or I don't know, or just once, or when you get engaged, or
your very first pet, also your pet, your dog or your cat, whatever.
Yeah.
No, I can't now.
Okay. Please, okay. Somebody wants to go next?
Thank you.
No problem, Aurora. Thank you.
Talk now or be quiet forever.
Or do you... please, Yamile. Thank you.
No. For me, it's talk in Spanish is difficult, or in English is more difficult.
But do you have your very first experience in something? Do you want to read? What do you want to do?
I don't know. My first experience. You are saying sexual.
Oh, God!
No. It's only. No.
Okay, your very first kiss?
When I was.
Good! I'm so happy, Yamile. You are going to do.
13 years? 13 years.
13. Because 30 is 30, and 13.
Ah, yes, 30.
No, I don't think so. 13.
She
said 30. 13. 13. 13. 13. 13. 13. 13. 13.
Yes, my first.
Okay. Please, can we correct at the end all the... In order not to correct the person.
Continue, Yamilet.
I don't know.
You just open the mouth.
I have an idea. I have an idea.
Okay. Go ahead, Maria.
Okay.
Maybe we could say everything we want to say, and at the end of the participation, we could, or you could correct.
Yeah,
in that way, you can listen or you can see what happened. What is the problem about the person about talking in speaking in English?
Yeah, it's what I said. At the end, we won't interrupt because we don't want to cut off the people, right? At the end, we want to, as you said, thank you, Mary. We want to correct. At the end, I'm going to write down, okay, maybe you can improve this and this word, the pronunciation word.
Okay, thank you.
No, okay, Mary, can you tell us your very first experience?
I have many first times. For example, I can tell you about my first time at work, because my first work was teaching, and I was 18, and all my pupils were older than me. And then it was really a problem because I was 18 and my younger student was 22. Then they, all of my students told me, oye tú, maybe speaking like in Spanish, de tú. And I was thinking, what can I do to have respect about speaking? And one older person told me, you should speak them de usted. It is not easy to say in English, because you and you is the same, okay, in English. And then I began to speak to my students, usted Juan, usted Pedro, please come on, please try, please read or something. But I talked to them, usted. That one was my very first time at work teaching.
Applause. Claps, please.
Thank you so much, Mary. The only thing that I can suggest to you is when you says my very first work, it's okay. But I think the proper way, everybody job. Will understand you. Everybody will understand you.
Very first job.
Yeah, you got it. Yeah. It's my very first job. Because if you said my very first work, everybody will understand you. Nobody's going to say anything, but they're going to say, oh, English is not her very first language.
Okay.
Yeah, but if it is your first, they will, that's why nobody wants to correct to you. But because it's not like grammatically wrong, but it's not like the way that we speak in native English. Yeah. That's why it's better if you says my first job.
Yeah, thank you.
I just found this one. I don't know if somebody can help.
But Marta, I want to know if you understood everything I said.
Yeah, I understood everything. And you really use the verbs in the right sentence. When it was past, you use in past. When it was in present, I understood everything. The only suggest that I can do is this one that you says my first work, but no, it's my first job. It's the only one that I found. That's why I said if somebody could find something that I didn't take it, somebody can help to Mary and me. Okay, I think we can go with the next one. Somebody wants to tell us his or her very first experience. Or you can repeat my experience if somebody doesn't have one experience. Or tell us
Hugo,
a joke.
Hugo,
oh, thank
Hugo,
you, Hugo.
Hugo is opening the mic.
Yeah.
Hello. I speak very little English. A friend gave me two information about the group. When she found out that started to study the language, I have 4 weeks studying English. I am 39 years old. I like practice cycling of the road on the mountain. And I want to talk to you about the first time I participate in a cycling event with a very long route of 175 kilometers. And one experience it's beautiful. It's hate and nervous and fear. No sé cómo se diga emocionante. But very
exciting.
Very exciting. Very exciting.
Okay, Hugo, please let me tell you and you will continue. Okay, let me tell you what I got from you. Okay,
okay.
I really want to say congratulations. You are like my hero. I really admire to you. I feel very inspiring by you. Porque tú dijiste, tengo 4 semanas y a mí me parece increíble tu nivel. Me parece increíble. Okay. You were telling us about, you said, I have 4 weeks just work studying English. Is right? Only 4 weeks?
Yeah.
And you said, I was in a, you said, in a cycling, you said cycle, what is cycling?
Cycling?
You were in a cycling experience. It was a good experience for you. You said you were cycling 126 kilometers?
Yes.
Congratulations. You said you were nervous.
Yes.
You know what? Can you tell us again? Can you repeat again with this? As I said, 4 weeks, cycling, one experience. I was nervous. Can you tell us again? Because I'm so happy for you. You are doing extremely good.
Maybe you can tell him how is the correct way and he can repeat it.
I think Hugo, okay, your name is in English will be Hugo. Hugo, do you want me to repeat in what I got from your experience or do you want to just say again?
Say again.
Okay. You have been studying English just for 4 weeks.
Yes.
You like to cycling. You were like in an event. You were cycling. You have to cycle 126 kilometers. You were nervous.
Yes.
I'm sorry, I didn't get any more. Can you tell us more?
Exciting.
You were very excited.
Fears o un poco de miedo. No sé.
Yeah. I was facing fears. Can you say again? I was facing fears. Can you say again, please? Repeat. I was facing fears.
I just waiting fears.
I was facing
fears. Okay.
Estaba, me enfrenté a miedos, estaba sintiendo miedos.
Okay.
I was facing fears.
Okay, thanks.
Okay, go ahead.
And I am personal.
I was personal.
Como, era como un reto, como romper límites.
For you, it was like
challenge.
Get over your limitations. My limitations.
It was a new challenge for you.
Yes, a challenge for me. Yes, and. In the finish,
when I finished,
I'm tired. It's dead. She's tired. So super.
You were exhausted. Exhausted. I was exhausted.
Can I you was say it? Exhausted. And
almost collapsed. Almost, yes. I was almost collapsed, like knockout.
Yeah. Yes, contento.
But so happy what I did.
But so happy, very happy.
What I did. Okay, is pero muy contento de lo que yo había hecho o lo que yo había logrado, but. Very happy what I did, de lo que hice, what I did.
Very happy what I did.
What I did.
Did.
Okay. But I was so happy what I did it. Did it. What I did it. Okay, great. I don't know.
Finish.
Okay, good. I need to say, please, guys, let's go to
congratulate
him. I'm so happy about you, Hugo. Okay. I don't know if somebody else want to suggest or to catch any word that to tell to Hugo and he can improve, guys.
Okay. Maybe he didn't understand.
Pardon me?
Maybe he didn't understand what you said.
Hugo, did you get me? ¿Me expliqué?
que si había, no.
When I said, did you get me? Is ¿tú me entendiste when I said, did you get me? ¿Tú me entendiste?
Okay. En de lo pasado, algunas cosas, no todo. Entendí un poco que platicaban como una experiencia de algo con el francés, de con una pareja, como que algo así, ¿no? De escalones que habían subido, algo así.
Oh, no, sorry. ¿No? Now I was asking you, ahora te preguntaba que, yo dije, ¿pueden alguien hacer alguien encontró una palabra que pueda decir que la pronuncie correctamente Hugo, and okay. Mari says, a lo mejor él no te entendió, entonces yo lo dije en español, alguien tiene, I don't know if somebody wants to tell something to Hugo to improve, or if somebody catch a word that he can improve.
No, little by little, maybe he doesn't remember now.
No, I think okay, for the time we need to go on, and I don't know, Angie, can or somebody else can tell us, can speak, and sing a song, or whatever they want to do.
Angie is open.
Good, Angie. Let's go, Angie, tell us.
Pues yo preparé my first time on plan.
My first time on a plan. Your very first plan in what?
My first time on a plan.
No, wait, Mari, please, Mari. Okay, look at my lips. It's first.
First.
No, first. Just No, fe, fers.
Fears, fers.
Fe. Say fe.
More or less.
Fe.
Fers.
Angie? Yeah. Okay, good. You got it.
My first time on a plan.
Okay, ¿hiciste un plan?
Plane. Mi primera vez en avión.
Plane.
Oh, plane. My very first. No, my very first fly. My very first. Please, Mari, if somebody wants to do a correction, can they put the hand off? Because okay. I don't wanna like. Like just we need to hand off put the hand off and we go ahead. Okay. Is is your very first
fly?
No, fly. Because you fly. were flying. Your very first fly.
My first repeat.
Fly. My very first. Fly.
My first time fly.
Flying.
Ya lo escribí.
Ya, yeah, I know, lo escribiste, pero hay que hacerle unas correcciones.
Voy a decir lo que sé decir y luego ya me corriges en cuanto a mi lectura, por favor.
Ok, sí.
Bueno. Hi, my name is Angie. I'm from East Mexico City. I am 42 years old. My first time on a plane, or como era?
Yeah, if now you said like that, it's fine. If you said my very first time in a plane or my very first fly. But in this way, what you want to tell us is my very first fly.
My very first fly. Very.
Or your first fly.
Or your first flight?
When I said yours, it's because it's two. But if you want to speak about you, you said my first fly.
Fly.
Yeah.
My first fly? My first fly. This was when I was 8 years old, and in addition to the experience of experiencing a flight.
You were 8 years old, ¿tenías 8 años?
Era mi sueño cuando yo tenía 8 años,
It was your dream. It was my dream.
Mi sueño cuando yo tenía 8 años.
Okay. It was my dream. It was my dream.
Sí.
Can you say again? It was my dream.
It was my dream. Uh-huh.
When I was 8 years old.
When? Yo me metí al traductor de plática en vivo y lo estuve copiando de ahí, entonces no es así, ¿verdad?
It can be, but when you...
Martita, yo no sé nada de inglés, no te entiendo.
Ok, no, sí, yo creo que sí está en lo correcto, pero a lo mejor fui yo la que no te entendí, entonces por eso, y es que hay muchas maneras de decirlo, Ajá, una cosa la puedes decir de muchas maneras, when you, cuando dijiste...
Bueno, yo creo que me vas a dar una sugerencia para empezar a pronunciar y ya, o sea, voy de poco a poco con vocabulario, con palabras, o no sé qué se puede hacer, porque pues, prácticamente me perdí toda la clase o la plática, en el sentido de que, pues, no entiendo.
Ok, sí, vamos a hacer, entonces, yo creo que vamos a cambiarlo, esta es la primera clase. Yo creo que a lo mejor vamos a ir como por niveles o vamos, o simplemente vámonos más despacio. Cuando yo hable, vámonos más despacio, podría ser eso.
Sí, yo estaba preparada, escribí toda mi primera vez.
Léelo, Angie, léelo.
Ok. My first time on a plane. This was when I was... 8 years old. And in addition to the experience of experiencing a flight. For the first time, a dream that I had as
can you turn off, please?
Came true. Since I was 8 years old, I dreamed of climbing de la mujer dormida o sleeping woman, volcano, a Isla Ciguat. Because Tosiguat was in the mountain or up to the top of it. On my first flight, the pilot opened his horn and asked us to look out the window and watch it fly around the mountain. Several laps. It was a wonderful gift. Thank you for listening to me.
Okay, Angie, muchas congratulations. I'm so happy that all the work that you did. I am really like inspired by you, what you did. And what I would like to suggest, lo que me gustaría recomendarte, muchas felicidades, me siento muy motivada con tu trabajo. Pienso que en este caso tenemos que ir paso a paso. Una experiencia, en este caso es una experiencia muy larga para el nivel que ahorita estás. Entonces, vamos a hacerlo en frases muy cortas, pero que esas frases cortas las tengas claras, las entiendas y no, tú lo entiendes todo, solo sería la pronunciación. Entonces, esas frases cortas, no vamos a tratar de hacer speeches o de hacer de decir 3 minutos. Vamos a tratar de hablar, no sé, 20 segundos, pero bien pronunciado. Con la pronunciación, porque vamos a ir poco a poco soltándonos al hablar, ¿verdad? Entonces, ahorita me parece que es muy largo y por ejemplo, la experiencia de Hugo fue corta y eso ayuda a que lo que él hable lo diga como que más claro. Entonces, en este caso es larga. No sé de lo que tú ahorita nos lo realizaste, si nos quieras nada más decir una idea de, porque en este yo conté 4 ideas, una con que viajaste en avión, otra que era un sueño, otra que estuviste visitando diferentes lugares. Entonces, son muchas ideas. Nada más vamos a tomar una idea y dinos esa idea y esa idea la vamos a corregir. La vas a pronunciar, la vas a repetir en inglés.
No, pues es que la idea va junta, porque cuando yo fui en el avión, mi primera vez fue un regalo que hayamos volado arriba de la mujer dormida. Y eso fue un
sueño que podría... Solo esa vamos a decir. When I was 8 years old, I got a dream to fly under the mujer dormida. Okay, can you repeat to me? When I was 8 years old, I got a dream to fly under the mujer dormida.
Si no te puedo decir ni la primera enunciado, ya me dijiste como 10.
Por eso te decía, tenemos que ir por frases cortas, pero tú dices, no, es que es todo junto. Entonces solo di, when I was 8 years old, I got a dream. Cuando tenía 8 años, realicé un sueño. When I was 8 years old, I did a dream. Or I got my very first dream.
Pues yo creo que lo voy a preparar para la otra clase porque se me olvida de inmediato que me lo dices. Lo tengo que practicar.
When I was 8 years old.
When I was 8 years old.
Yeah, when I was 8 years old.
When I was
eight years old,
I had a dream. Okay. Little by little, poquito a poquito, okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay. I don't know if somebody else can go next.
Yes, we have a hand raised. It's Yamilet. Yamilet, your turn. You want to speak? There is a hand. I thought you want to speak, Yamilet, but it's not. Because I saw your hand.
No encontraba mi micrófono.
Okay.
Okay, Marta, can you correct me my English in this song?
Sure.
Okay.
I'm good.
I sing.
Okay.
Tell me something, boy. I'm tired trying to fill that boy. Or do you need more?
And wow! Please, guys, I think she needs a close. Okay. Go, guys.
Okay.
Oh, so happy. Oh, thank you, Yamile, what you did for us tonight. Thank you, so pretty. Muchas felicidades, Yamile. Gracias por este regalo. Muy bonita canción.
Okay, thank you.
Please do again. Can you do again for us?
Sí,
la puedes volver a cantar. Me parece muy bonita canción. Okay. O muy bonito el detalle que tuviste para nosotros.
Okay, again. Tell me something, boy. I'm tired trying to fill that void. Or do you need more? And in heart keeping is so hardcore. I'm falling. In all the good times, I find myself longing for change. And in the bad times, I feel myself. Okay.
Thank you. Okay.
Cool.
I would like to correct to you.
Uh-huh.
You did great, extremely good. When you say something, you say something, but it's say something. You need to put your tongue out.
Something.
Something. Your tongue, your tu lengua, abres bien la boca. Cuando dices la M la haces con los labios. Muy bien. Cuando dices thing, cuando es H-T-H, sacas la lengua, así textual, sacas la lengua.
Ok.
Something. Ya, lo tienes. Cuando es la M, siempre es con los labios. Cuando vas a pronunciar la M, hazlo con los labios. Y cuando es TH, siempre que hay una TH, sacas la lengua.
Okay.
Al inicio lo haces muy marcado porque no estamos acostumbrados. Lo tienes que hacer muy marcado. Okay. Ya después fluye, ya después lo haces sin darte cuenta. Pero es something.
Something.
Ok. Esa fue una que pude escuchar clara. Y las otras, parece que tu pronunciación es muy buena.
Ok. Thank you.
No sé si alguien, Neto, o alguien quisiera hacer una algo que hayan encontrado en Yamile.
No, muchas felicidades. Doble felicitación para Yamilet, doble felicitación. Gracias por cantar, gracias por ponerte ahora sí que valiente, mostrándonos que sí se puede. Muchas gracias. No han hablado, fíjense, nomás vienen aquí de observadores, Julio y María Félix. Así es que aprovechen este tiempo para que ustedes que no han hablado, aprovechenla y practiquen. Platiquen su
por favor, Julio y María Félix tienen que hablar, porque yo creo que no lo dije. But I need to say the only condition, you don't need to pay anything. Thank you for your time, but you need to if you are here, you need to say something, please. No hay ningún costo. Les agradezco mucho su tiempo, pero la única condición es que tienen que hablar, cantar, lo que sea, pero tenemos que escuchar su voz.
Bueno, yo estoy en ceros, la verdad no le entiendo.
Mari,
pues son pequeñas palabritas que he aprendido con mi niño de la primaria, ¿no? Nada más.
Ok, Telos, dinos esas palabritas.
Pues nada más es que es red, blue, ¿qué otro? Ya se me fue la onda. Yellow. Ajá. Entonces, por ejemplo, ahorita anoté unas palabras que estaban diciendo, pero me dice mi hijo, el de Nueva York, que no están bien escritas. Entonces, por ahí, pues ya empezamos mal.
No, pero a lo mejor, porque es diferente, ¿verdad? A lo mejor no las escribiste bien, pero las puedes pronunciar. A mí me pasa mucho, ¿no? A veces, yo digo, ay, bueno, ya así la escribo, a mí que nada más la voy a pronunciar al rato, pero yo sé que no la estoy escribiendo bien.
Por ejemplo, escribí my friends, pero pues como así como tal, como lo escuché, así lo escribí, pero me dice mi hijo que no se escribe así.
¿Qué escribiste, Mari?
My friends.
¿My friends?
My friends, dice él que se...
My friends. Pero di my friends.
Perdón, okay, que te interrumpa. ¿Y en my friends se pronuncia la T?
¿Dónde hay una T en friends? Cuando se escribe no lleva T.
Ah, es que a mí me salió... Pero
me dices cómo se escribe.
S-T. Entonces le quito la T.
F-R-I-E-N. Aquí me lo puedes mostrar, Angie, cómo lo encontré. ¿Dices que hay una T?
Esta es aquí para yo saber. Ahí.
No, ahí dice first, my first. This is first. Y Mari dijo friends. Judy, Mari, oh, ¿dijiste okay. my first or my friends?
My friends.
F-R-I-E-N-D-S.
Friends.
Ok, es friends, pero es F-R-E-I-N-D-S. Friends.
¿Sin la I?
No, lleva E-I.
Ah, ok, ok.
Friends. A lo mejor yo lo estoy escribiendo mal.
¿Se dice?
Así diría friends.
Pues acá está mi hijo, dice que no es así.
O es F-R-I-E. I-E. I-E, friends.
Sí, así lo escribió él, así me lo enseñó.
Sí, es I-E, friends, pero es my friends, my friends.
Okay. Sí, sí, así está. Gracias.
Ok, ok, sigue.
Pues más que nada es eso, y que era lo que dijeron hace rato, que were happy, que yo entendí que estaba feliz, algo así.
I was happy.
Ajá, pero no lo supe escribir, yo nomás puse were happy, nada más.
When, happy. When, ¿cuándo o dónde? ¿Cuándo estabas feliz o dónde estabas feliz?
Pues, estoy feliz, ¿no? Por ejemplo.
O entonces es I am happy. Y si estás, es I am happy.
¿Y cómo se escribe?
Is I, es I, es I. ¿Y? No, no. I latina. I is I.
Ajá.
A, espacio. Am, es A-M. Am.
Ok.
Espacio. Happy es H-A-P-P-Y.
Happy. Y. Ah, ok, ok. I am happy, ¿no? Es, se pronuncia.
Sí, I am happy. Okay. Gracias, Mari.
Ok, muchas gracias, Martita.
No, a ti, Mari. Ahora solo nos falta Julio.
Yes, solo falta Julio. Julio.
Hi. Hola, buenas noches. Disculpen, pero no sé mucho inglés. Recién también estoy nuevo en esta área de aprender inglés. Buenas noches con todos. Good night. Pero me encantaría poder comenzar. Siempre me ha gustado el inglés, ¿saben? Pero no he podido. Soy de Perú, ¿no? No he podido en ese aspecto por el tiempo y la dificultad que se me hacía para poder practicarlo con fluidez o compartirlo con alguien, pero siempre he averiguado en YouTube o ahora en las redes se puede aprender, creo que en internet, ¿no? Hay una frase que me gustaría decir en inglés, que si la pronuncio bien, no sé si estaría bien.
A ver.
La frase es así. You can, nothing can stop you and trust you, you can. If you have fallen, then get up. Because you can get up. You are going to get it put every day in good hands. Put every day in good hands. You can. Es una frase que a veces con la escucha, me gusta practicar bastante con la escucha, a veces sin entender el significado a veces. Me cuesta investigar ahí por todo eso, pero esa es la frase que más, no sé si me llegaron a entender.
Sí, yo sí te, la verdad es escuchaba la, ok, let me, yo sí, ay, no está funcionando este. ¿Hello?
Hi, hello. Sí.
Se escucha bien, se escucha bien.
Se escucha, okay.
Es que yo no te, Julio, no te podía escuchar. se escuchaba como sonido. Entonces, no te quise interrumpir, pero por favor, yo lo poco que escuché sí lo pronunciaste bien, pero te digo, se escuchaba como no lo escuché correctamente.
Debe ser por mi YouTube.
Es que, ¿verdad?, se escucha como ruidoso, como...
Ajá, como...
No sé, como raro. Como si ahora fuera fantasma o algo así, no sé cómo.
Ahora
algo
se raro. Bien.
Sí, ahora se escucha mejor.
Sí, ya se
escucha. Ahí,
ya, ahí. Creo que mis auriculares de Bluetooth están a veces fallando.
Sí.
Debe ser eso. No, me gustaría volver a repetirlo porque es una frase que me encanta, en la cual yo más puedo aprender inglés, yo siento que son con las frases que me motivan a hacerlo, ¿no? O ya sean con cosas que quiero hacerlo y frases que siempre pegan, ¿no? Sí. Eso es lo que actualmente estoy practicando. No estoy en ningún instituto ni nada para... Pero sí, me gustaría aprender más y esta es una oportunidad para todos tratar de aprender, ¿no?
Sí.
Y me gustaría volver a repetirlo. You can, nothing can stop you from you, you can. If you have fallen, then get up because you can get up. You are going to get up.
Por favor, ahí, por favor, te voy a interrumpir. No quería hacer esto, pero es que unas como que se cortó, no sé qué pasó.
Quita el video, no tener... para que se escuche mejor tienes que quitar el video y así tienes mejor internet.
A ver, creo que sí es el internet. A ver, vamos a... Ahora sí me llegan a escuchar bien, no lo sé, creo que es mi internet.
Sí, ahorita ya se escucha bien.
I am from Peru. Ok.
Sí, ya se escucha bien, esto ya lo entendí, se entendió perfecto. ¿Puedes, por favor, otra vez empezar? Y creo que ahora sí ya estamos bien.
Yo me voy a hacer un cafecito y unos frijolitos.
Ok, lo que quiero contarles es que no sé inglés y me gustaría aprender, ¿no?
Uh-huh.
Es una frase que me gusta. Siempre me ha gustado aprender inglés, pero no he tenido la enseñanza para poder hacerlo, ¿no? Pero me gustaría tener la oportunidad de seguir aprendiendo, ¿no? No sé mucho de inglés, no sabría qué decirlo.
Ok, ahora puedes decirnos tu frase o la frase, por favor.
Ok. You can, nothing can stop you and trap you. You can. If you have fallen, then get up because you can get up. You are going to get up, put every day in good hands. Put every day in good hands. You can.
Put everything in good hands. Do you mean that? ¿Quieres decir eso? Put everything in hands. Hands.
A ver.
And you said because?
En español lo que quiero decir es que tú puedes, nada te puede detener, yo confío en ti, tú puedes. Si has caído, pues okay. Levántate. Porque tú puedes, levántate, lo vas a conseguir, pon todo en las manos de Dios, pon todo en las manos de Dios, tú puedes.
Sí, velo diciendo, por favor, lo puedes ir diciendo frases cortas. Yo creo que...
Claro. You can, comienza con tú puedes, you can.
Ya.
You can.
¿Sí?
Nothing can stop you.
Nothing. Julio, cuando no. Otra vez, cuando esté la TH, Saca la lengua, por favor, si no, no se te va a entender.
Nothing. Nothing.
Saca la lengua, saca. Ok, ahora sí se escuchó nothing, ok. Okay,
no, nothing. Okay. ¿Correcto?
Sí.
I trust you.
I trust. Trust.
I trust you.
Trust you?
I trust you.
Trust of you. Trust on you. Or trust on you. Trust on you. Confío trust. En ti. O creo en ti. Trust on trust. You.
Trust on you. Okay. You can.
You can.
If you have fallen, then get up.
If you have fallen, get off. If you have fallen. If you have fallen, get off. You can get up. No,
you can get up.
Sí.
Okay. You can fallen get up.
¿Lo puedes repetir?
You can if you have fallen, get up.
Sí. If you have fallen, get up. Get up.
Get up.
No, she didn't
if
say.
If you fallen, get up.
Okay.
Yes?
No.
Oh, no.
No.
No. Okay.
If you have fallen, you can get up. You can get up. Okay, sí. Go on.
Because you can get up.
Sí.
You are going to get it. Correct?
Can you say again?
You are going to get up. ¿Lo vas a conseguir?
You are going to get it. Get it.
You are going to get it.
Yeah. You are going to get it. Pero si lo decimos como que todo rápido o no, no rápido, pero. Perdón. Pero si lo dices corrido, por eso.
No se speak English.
No. Por eso lo estoy diciendo en español para que lo pronuncies en inglés y ya y salga corridito. You are going to get it. Lo vas a obtener. You are going to get it.
Thank you.
Just say again. Solo repite la última. You are going to get it.
You are going to get it.
Okay. Gracias, Julio.
Tenemos a dos nuevas personas que han de llegar, Cristina y Barrio.
Gracias a ustedes por escucharme. Muchas gracias.
Gracias, Julio.
No sé, por la hora, no sé a qué horas llegaron, Neto.
No, de hecho ya entraron y se salieron, ya se fueron. Nomás venían de mirones y ya se fueron. No, Barrio sí se quedó, Barrio Elizabeth.
Pero te digo, ya son las 9:11.
Es cierto.
Y no sé, solo tenemos un invitado, es un invitado nativo, tenemos un invitado, nos hizo el favor de venir, de acompañarnos, porque es un nativo de la lengua inglesa. Entonces, sí quisiera, pues, presentarlo y que nos diera su primera experiencia, porque nos hizo el favor de venir y de compartir con nosotros su primera experiencia en inglés. Él solo habla inglés y, pues, es un nativo su lengua madre es el inglés, él nació en Canadá. Entonces, ahora lo voy a decir en inglés. We have a guest. I really want to introduce him because he came all this way 1 hour to my place just to tell us, to share with us his very first experience in something, I don't know what it's going to be, but I'm going to really introduce him because he came here all the way, 1 hour wait just for sharing with us. Hizo un viaje de 1 hora solo para compartir con nosotros su experiencia y podamos escuchar una persona en su lengua nativa, que es el inglés. Okay, can you go?
Thank you for you.
Okay, can you sit up and you introduce yourself?
Okay. Hola, hello.
Hello.
This is my first time.
Welcome, Mexico.
Hello. Hi.
My name is Mike. Is this the camera? Is the camera's right here?
Yeah.
Hi, my name is Mike, and
No. The camera is.
Camera is where?
The camera. Right here. Oh, sorry. Yeah, it's there.
No, sorry. Yes, my name is Mike, and I'm born in Toronto, and. My family comes from Europe, from a very small country called Malta in Europe. And so I live in Toronto, and I lived here for all my entire life. And this is my first time talking to many people and learning, I guess, people that are trying to learn, like yourselves, trying to learn English. And I'm the same as you, trying to learn Spanish. So, and it's, you never give up, and because I'm always trying to learn Spanish myself. I guess today's class is about, I guess, what your first experience, like what you've, first experience. I'm going to try to talk very slow. So just because it's hard for you to understand, right? Did they understand? Does everybody understand me so far? Where I'm from? Mike, from?
Yes.
Toronto.
You are from Toronto and your family is from Malta.
Oh, yes, very good. We have a student that's advanced. That's very good. Okay, so I guess I'm going to talk about a vacation. I guess for the first time I've been to the Cayman Islands in the Gulf. I guess it's in the Gulf of Mexico, the Grand Cayman Islands. It was many, many years ago, and I don't know. I went to go meet my brother and his family that was traveling to the Grand Cayman Islands, and I went by myself to go and visit him and his family. And one experience that I can talk about that was very unique to me was there are very small tropical fish. Red colors, yellow, blue, many, many fish. And these fish, they eat right from your hands. You can bring the bread to the ocean, to the coral reefs, and they come right to you and they eat. So this experience was very unique to me. It was fun because I went with my brother It was called snorkeling. How do you say snorkeling?
I don't know in Spanish.
Snorkeling, when you go in the water by your, with the flippers.
Aletas.
And you can see you can see a whole new world in the ocean. So my brother was with me, my older brother, and I brought lots of food with me. So we were out in the ocean, and it was a very funny moment because the fish were very hungry. So I put the bread with my brother, and all the fish were following my brother in the ocean. I put it. They went in his, how do you say bathing suit? Because maybe they don't
understand. No, just in English.
Oh, they went in, I put it in his bathing suit, in the back of his shorts, and all the fish was going inside his, in his bathing suit. So this was a very unique experience for me. It was my first time. So it was a very fun trip and experience. So that's me. Anyways, if anybody wants to ask me something or practice something to say, I can help as well. I'm very nice to meet you all. Everybody's from Mexico?
No, from Peru. There is one people from Peru.
Some from Peru.
Julio is from Peru.
Oh, very nice. I would like to visit Peru someday.
Me too.
As well. It's a very beautiful country. So does anybody want to say anything?
You give me a good idea to make a prank putting bread in the bathing suit. Thank you.
Oh, you caught it.
Thank you.
It was so many fish. It was a very fun experience. I couldn't believe that all of these fish were just come right to you. They're like so innocent. I mean, I never seen that before, because normally they run, they swim away and they're scared. But these fish, they all came to you. Like, it was like, they were so used to it. It was a good prank. It was my big brother.
Okay, I don't know. Okay, I think.
That's everything?
Yeah, thank you.
Oh, thank you. Very nice to meet you all. Have a good night. I'll give you to Martha.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, guys. I think we passed the hour. I don't know if somebody wants to say something, because we are just saying goodbye, the last minute to say goodbye.
Se iba a traducir.
Okay, Angie. Dinos, telos. Telos, Angie, telos.
Yeah, telos, Angie.
No.
¿Qué entendiste, mira, Angie? A ver, dinos, ¿qué entendiste? Vamos a ver qué
entendiste. Sabes perfecto que estoy cotorreando. Nada.
Nada. A ver, ¿qué te imaginas que dijo? A ver, ¿qué te imaginas que dijo Angie?
Mira, él dijo, mucho gusto, soy de Toronto, de Canadá, muchas veces estuve en México, una vez me sumergí en el fondo del mar y estaba mi hermano, y entonces yo salí y me gustó mucho y te saludo a ti, ya no supe nada.
Muy bien.
No, sí, dijo muchas cosas de las que dijiste. Sí, estaba con su hermano. Okay. I don't know if somebody wants to say something. ¿Alguien más quiere decir algo, despedirse?
María Félix. Ah, no es cierto.
Bueno, no, pues muchas gracias, más que nada. Entonces, okay. Thank you. Muchas gracias.
Okay.
Por tu tiempo, por todo.
Gracias. No, gracias a ustedes.
Gracias, muchas Marta, gracias.
Thanks for your time.
Por soportarnos.
No.
Muchas gracias y que continúen las clases, sí. Gracias.
Yes, yes, yes.
¿Cómo podría yo saber, disculpen, para estar en las siguientes clases, si lo podría?
Sí, vamos a hacerlo semanalmente, una semana yo y una semana Marta, ya hablamos de eso. Y puedes mandarme un mensaje de WhatsApp, ahorita te mando un WhatsApp con mi número para que te esté informando por WhatsApp.
Gracias, gracias, muchas gracias.
Ya lo puse ahí en el WhatsApp y va a ser una vez por semana. Y lo que sí estoy ahorita observando es que hubo algunos detalles que vamos a afinar Marta y yo en la semana, porque sí vi que el nivel de inglés es muy diferente. Entonces, eso es el único detalle que vi en la clase de hoy y me parece que hay que ajustar eso, porque si vamos a querer hacer esto más fluido, necesitamos hacer algunos cambios en la enseñanza. Entonces, Marta y yo nos vamos a poner de acuerdo. Muchas gracias, Marta. Te quiero un chorro. Gracias por tu servicio, Marta. Muchas gracias.
Muchísimas gracias. Gracias, gracias, gracias.
Gracias. Bien.
Thank you.
Gracias, gracias por su tiempo a todos.
Gracias, Neto. Welcome. Gracias, Martita. Gracias a tu novia, no sé cómo se llama.
Gracias.
Welcome. Have a good night.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Gracias. Bye.